Out front tonight, the breaking news, a no-show. Attorney General Bill Barr refusing tonight to testify before the House Judiciary Committee tomorrow morning. It comes after a five-hour grilling by the Senate Judiciary Committee. During that hearing, Barr ripping into a damning letter from Robert Mueller himself, a letter in which Mueller criticized Barr for his summary of the Mueller report's findings.
You know, the letter's a bit snitty, and I think it was probably written by one of his staff people.
A bit snitty. It was a two-page letter, and obviously it was a really important letter, so Mueller signed it himself. Whoever may have written parts of it or not clearly was okay with every word. Stafford didn't sign it. Special counsel himself signed it. It's clear Barr and Mueller are at odds over some of the most basic black-and-white findings from Mueller's report. Take cooperation and Mueller's findings that the president repeatedly tried to thwart the investigation.
Do you think it's fully cooperating to instruct a former aide to tell the attorney general to unrecuse himself, shut down the investigation, and declare the president did nothing wrong?
I don't think, well, obviously, since I didn't find it was obstruction, I felt that the evidence could not support an obstruction.
I'm asking if that's fully cooperating. Yeah. I'm not asking whether that's obstruction. Is that fully cooperating?
Yeah, he fully cooperated.
Okay, that sounds really strange. He fully cooperated. It is strange. It's the exact opposite of what Mueller determined. Mueller, for example, writes about a meeting that the president had with Corey Lewandowski about a message the president wanted Corey Lewandowski to deliver to Jeff Sessions. Let me read it to you. This is from the Mueller report. The message said that Sessions should publicly announce that notwithstanding his recusal from the Russia investigation, the investigation was very unfair to the president did nothing wrong, and Sessions planned to meet with a special counsel and let him move forward with investigating election meddling for future elections. Well, of course, that's not fully cooperating. It sure doesn't sound like Mueller thought that's what was happening. And that was not the only time that Barr's testimony didn't add up today. Barr was also pressed about this exchange from April 9th.
Reports have emerged recently, General, that members of the special counsel's team are frustrated at some level with the limited information included in your March 24th letter. That it does not adequately or accurately necessarily portray the report's findings. Do you know what they're referencing with that?
No, I don't.
The pause may have been much more significant than the answer, no, I don't. I'm going to talk to Congressman Crist, who asked that question in a moment, because, of course, the reason the pause matters so much is because Barr did know that the special counsel's team felt Barr's memo did not adequately portray Mueller's findings. He'd already received a letter from Mueller, which said Barr's memo, quote, did not fully capture the context, nature, and substance of the special counsel's work and conclusions. Today, Barr was asked about what he said to Congressman Crist. Given that we now know Barr had already seen Mueller's letter when Crist questioned him, Barr did what? I mean, what's the word here to use? Misled? Lied? Listen for yourself.
When I talked to the special counsel about the letter, my understanding was his concern was not the accuracy of the statement of the findings in my letter, but that he wanted more out there to provide additional context to explain his reasoning on why he didn't reach a decision on obstruction.
His understanding was Mueller was not concerned about the accuracy of Barr's letter. Again, Mueller's letter says Barr's summary, quote, did not fully capture the context, nature, and substance of the special counsel's work and conclusions. Maybe Barr's trouble with the truth today is part of why he is refusing to appear tomorrow and take questions from Congress and, the big dispute, congressional lawyers.